ने दी थी कि जी हम ये मेरी कैंडिडेट होंगी इस रिजर्व सीट, जब तक ये आपका नहीं आएगा थोड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है. एनी लेडी कैन कम अप एंड से कि आई वांट मे बी आई एम द कैंडिडेट, तो वो फिर बात बहुत खुल जाएगी.
बल्कि इसको थोड़ा बढ़ा
तो
बल्कि इसको बढ़ा
उधर आपने अबैंडन कर दिया ना.
नहीं अबैंडन नहीं किया,
आपने कहा यू जॉइंड यू वांट टू जॉइन एसआईसी.
आई एम सेइंग इफ एसआईसी इज अलाउड देन आई विल जॉइन एसआईसी.
एसआईसी ने अभी तक लिस्ट जमा नहीं किया, अगर लिस्ट जमा करेंगे हो सकता है
अगर ना भी करें वो सिर्फ इतना ओन आपको कर ले फिर आप आ सकते
हैं. सलमान साहब जरा सुन ले,
आई अश्योर द कोर्ट आई विल गेट दैट सर्टिफिकेट.
एक मिनट जरा सुन ले, देखिए
मुझे सुन ले अगर ऑन क्वेश्चन
ले आए अगर एसआईसी ने
लिस्ट ले आए फिर
अभी विद इन द आवर आ जाएगी. अलाउ मी टू बिगिन, आई विल अलाउ मी टू कमेंस.
अगर आप एसआईसी के लिस्ट उन्होंने जमा ही नहीं किया है, सुन ले एक बार, अगर एसआईसी ने अपने लिस्ट जमा नहीं किया और एसआईसी की पिटीशन अलाउ होती है तो आपको ज्वाइन कर देंगे
जी. सो एसआईसी ने दरखास्त दी कि हमें लिस्ट देने दें, उनको देने नहीं दी गई.
आपने ये बातें कर ली कितनी दफा कर ली,
मुझे आर्ग्यू करने दें थोड़ा सा. क्वेश्चन
आर्ग्यू कर रहे हैं समझ नहीं आ रहा है. आप उनका केस तबाह करने पे आप करना चाहिए तबाह उनका.
आई डोंट नो ये आप क्यों कह रही है, बट
बिकॉज यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट. यू थिंक टुडे आई वेयर वन टाई, टुमारो आई कैन वेयर अनदर टाई. सुन तो लीजिए ना, पॉलिटिकल एफिलिएशन इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग.
यस नॉट
और इट इज नॉट,
इट इज नॉट, इट इज, बट आई एम नॉट going to other cross purposes.
तो political parties affiliation होना होता है.
आप certificate इसी stage के ऊपर दे रहे हैं, तो वो क्या agree करेगा?
Kindly read article
stage के ऊपर.
Kindly read clause 2 of article 224 of the constitution.
Article 224.
Yes, clause 2.
When the National Assembly or a Provincial Assembly is dissolved, a general election to the Assembly shall be held within a period of 90 days after the dissolution, and the results of the election shall be declared not later than 14 days after the conclusion of the polls.
Now let's relate this to what we have before us, namely paragraph D of 51, which is of course proportionate to whatever it is.
Yes,
ma'am. It seems to me that since the constitution mandates, so I'm not sure exactly what happened in this general election, because but anyway, the constitutional mandate is that results have to be declared of the general election not later than 14 days after the conclusion of the polls. So that as a matter of law crystallizes the position of the proportional representation.
Right.
You at that time had filed the list for PTI. I mean, you were on the reserve list for PTI.
Yes, that was filed way back in December.
So, 2023. It seems to me, prima facie, that since the right of PTI crystallized as a matter of law on the 14th day, your right to be considered, if they were
yes.
number crystallized at that point in time.
Making argue करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. If I am allowed to come to the question of law, I bow.
अरे बात तो सुन लेना आप. माशाल्लाह मुकदा आजकल कोई बात.
अब अपने फेवर की बात भी नहीं सुन
रहे हैं. Therefore, the question of locus standi prima facie seems answered.
Right, so
that you have a standing. Now the question is, you are standing before us how? My learned colleague Justice Atul Minallah has made his, I think, a very practical observation that let us not get caught up in the technicalities of the matter, since as a matter of constitutional law you seem to have, the position seems to have crystallized for the reserved seats, and you being on the reserved list seems to me that prima facie you do have standing to say, well, whatever it is you want to say.
I'm grateful for that observation. My humble plea is, hear me out and then let us see whether what I have to say makes out a cause of action on my part or not. And I bow completely that if your lordships were to come to the conclusion, and there is nothing stopping your lordships,
if we allow you to argue, how long will you take?
An hour and 20 minutes.
No way. If you can make a few points,
you're not important.
Indulgence hai, fir aap
indulgence. It is not indulgence.
Yes, it is indulgence. If you don't even concede it as indulgence,
I'm,
that is not fair.
No, Murad, my solution
is
I am the person most impacted. We should
करने दें. बार बार आप वही बात कर रहे हैं.
शुरू करने दें.
चंद मिनटों में कोई points बताना हम note.
मतलब मुझे शुरू करने दें.
अगर आप घंटों लगाएंगे हम आपको नहीं.
No, not घंटों, but maybe an hour or so. But
no, hour or so.
ये सलमान राजा साहब.
Then I'll.
No, but the.
अब सुन ले.
We are giving you an indulgence.
So let us see if
why
I have
don't
something
you start
useful
and
to
then
say.
We see how it
yes,
goes.
But I need
so
to
much
know
time
that
is taken up in this.
I have some time to make a.
Let's
I would
proceed
have
with
done
your
half
argument.
The by now,
आप शुरू करें फिर आप
शुरू तो करें.
Abandon all work. सिर्फ आपके केस सुनेंगे हम. There are thousands of cases in the Supreme Court.
Yes,
has a pity on those people.
Murad, this is a foundational case of great importance for the future of democracy in this country. Now let me just make a few points, and let's see where these points go. Then
give us your contentions first, and then elaborate on it later.
And I will then submit a note as well. So my first submission is, and I'm now purely on the questions of law and the Constitution, that in Article 51(6). D and E, there is in the text of these articles no requirement whatsoever that an independent candidate join a party with at least one seat, directly one, at the time of the general election. There is nothing in the text.
आगे बढ़िए.
मुझे अर्ज करने दें सर. This requirement has been read into the text by both the Election Commission and the Peshawar High Court. And it would appear that this reading in has occurred because of a failure to appreciate the effect of the proviso in both these sub clauses D and E, and the use of the word secured in sub clause D, and the word or the phrase proviso won by in the proviso to sub clause D, as well as the use of the phrase won in both the main body and the proviso of sub clause E.
This is the exact same point argued by Mr. Professor.
It is exactly not. Murad, kindly hear me.
Chale, aage badhiye. Next point bataiye.
No, kindly hear me.
Next point bataiye.
No, it's not the next point. I need to elaborate this. Isi pe. If my Lord will allow me, Murad will take much shorter. So the submission is, my friend was arguing that perhaps some purposive, progressive interpretation is needed. I am submitting no progressive or purposive interpretation is needed. In fact, the very language of these clauses belies the contention that it is a sequential process whereby first one seat has to be won in the general election and only then further seats can be won through the independent members joining a party. So the language here is that independent members may join a political party, not a parliamentary party. So if the constitution makers wanted the independent members to join a party with at least one seat, the language used would have been parliamentary party.
Can't be, because at this point in time
there is no
parliamentary party, because parliament has not yet, or the National Assembly.
All right, so okay, I concede that. So the language used here is political party.
No, but you see, the thing is, you are not speaking for myself. Keeping in mind is that the main part, I'm looking at D now.
Yes.
Main part says seat secured by each political party.
Yes.
Seat secured.
Yes.
The proviso is speaking of the independent returned candidate joining.
Yes.
There's a distinction here.
Lord.
As I see it, suppose there is a general election, and the next morning someone asks another person, how many seats did party X secure? Whatever the answer is. And suppose that person asks the question in this way.
3 days later.
How many seats did party X win? Would you, as a reasonable person, draw any distinction? No. How many seats did the party secure? How many seats did the party win?
No.